in first 10 15 20 minutes, and then possibly we will open up for your questions, for your sharing, based on the number of participants that we have. We'll have to decide how do we do the interaction. So I think most likely we will have to take your thoughts and your comments over a chat, and somebody from the team will start sharing it with everyone over the voice also. So that's the format that we wish to follow as we get into this webinar, adversities as opportunities. So let us move ahead and see what does this time mean. So these are few words which we all think we all can relate to this. The list can go on and go on and go on, but these are all very common words which I'm sure we all can relate to, looking at the current situation that we have in front of us. So it is a difficult time. They are adverse. They are not something which were favorable. They are challenging. They bring a lot of uncertainty. Not sure what will happen tomorrow, how it will unfold, who will get more impacted, who will survive, who will not survive. There are a lot of constraints now. So there are a lot of constraints. It's not like that same environment or same normal kind of a situation where the constraints have been less. So there are a lot of constraints in front of us, constraints in terms of movement, resources, travel, economy. So there are a lot of constraints here. Certainly these are not normal situations, for sure. These are not normal. These are absolutely beyond normal, below normal, or adversely normal situation, which nobody had predicted. In fact, when we were doing this Innopreneur finale in Nagpur on 1st and 2nd of Feb, where I think many of you were there in Nagpur for that competition, we didn't have even slightest of clue that something will happen in next 2 months after the event, and we would be addressing this kind of a webinar for adversity time. So I think nobody had clue. Best of the economists, best of the sociologists, best of the psychologists, best of the anthropologists, nobody had clue of this kind. But yeah, this is how the reality is, and we bring in such times where we are normally we would feel down, normally we would feel low, normally we would feel okay. अब क्या होगा नहीं पता. सो दिस आर वेरी नेचुरल फीलिंग्स दैट एवरी वन ऑफ अस विल गो थ्रू, एंड आई एम ऑल्सो बीइंग पार्ट ऑफ द सेम काइंड ऑफ फीलिंग. सो देयर इज नथिंग लाइक वी ऑल आर ह्यूमन बीइंग्स, सो वी ऑल वुड डेफिनेटली गो थ्रू द सेम फीलिंग, बट देयर इज डेफिनेटली ए ब्राइटर साइड ऑफ इट ऑल्सो. सो एंड अनलेस वी स्टार्ट लुकिंग एट द ब्राइटर साइड, आई थिंक will not be able to take advantage of the situation. So there is definitely a small brighter side. Even after this adversities, uncertainties, difficulties, challenging times, I think let's look at few things which can bring smile on our faces, which we can take it as an opportunity for us during this unprecedented time. So what are this kind of opportunities are for us? So let us keep swimming now. So the underlining message for every one of us, including me, is keep swimming. And that is what we are trying to do over this webinar, that in fact, after almost a month kind of a break for us, we finally realize we need to keep swimming. There is no way that we can stop our swimming or stop our effort. So the first thing that we all have to do is get upbeat, get positive about it, and let's swim. I'm sure we will be able to swim in our own best possible way and come out of this turmoil very soon. So as we see, the situation in front of us is very constrained. I think this kind of situations have always proven to be the best situation for optimization. So because we are constrained, because we don't have those luxuries of all the resources in front of us, these are the best times to optimize. Now, this optimization can happen at any level. In fact, an individual can also shed their extra fats during this time. But from a professional point of view, I think whatever daily routine we are into, whatever time schedule we are into, whatever startup we are into, whatever venture creation we are into, whatever professional journey we are into, I think we have some extra fat which got accommodated over last many, many years. And we could use this opportunity to really shed off those fat. Non-needful things, non-useful stuff, non-useful resources, non-useful stuff in our profession or startup or our venture can now really be shed off. So these are times to get optimized. Yes, we don't have the luxury of so many resources in front of us. We need to get optimized now. So if you are in a startup, you would have automatically realized that, okay, with the lean resources, with less number of people, with less number of resources, time and opportunities, we have to learn to swim now. So we have to get into that lean model. We have to optimize our operation. We'll have to optimize our cost. We'll have to also optimize our time. So there are a few things we need to get optimized. And these are the only times when we can really and very critically, maybe in a compelled manner, but the output is going to be good after this time is over. Now that outside is all stopped. So the outside world is kind of a halt. The business activity is halt. The movement of people is on halt. We are all in a lockdown inside few square feet of our house. So that's the kind of a situation where we, most of us are in. And these are the times when we get best possible opportunity to look inside. So because outside is all halted. So again, maybe not by choice, by compulsion, but eventually it's for our betterment that, okay, we finally start looking inside. Inside means I am more referring to inside your venture, inside your organization, and see what best things could be done there. This is the time to optimize. This is the time to set your processes in place. This is the time to bring the standardization inside your organization. This is the time to do a lot of things which probably would be pending for long. So focus inside. This is the time. This time will never come. Probably it's a lifetime opportunity for all of us, because I'm sure we used to listen to our parents when they used to talk to us that, okay, there used to be an India-Pakistan war, or there used to be an India-China war, and there used to be emergency situations, and this is how we were stuck up, and this is how we used to manage our life and all that. So similarly, I think we would also share this kind of feedback. We would also share this kind of input to our children and grandchildren in future to come. But these are the best time for us as an opportunity, because we are fortunate, at least we have so many resources at our disposal. We are inside our house. We have family with us. We have internet with us. We have so much of things that we could still do sitting inside our house. That's the big change in which for people when they had last seen the kind of emergencies, and now that we are witnessing this emergency. So technology and internet have come as a big boom during this emergency times as compared to what we had seen in the past. So let's focus inside. There's a lot of things that we can do internally inside our organization, because outside is all closed. Change. Yeah, it's changing now. The degree of change has been so rapid in last 45 days. If you would realize, in last 45 days from 1st March, not even 1st March, I would say it's about 13th, 14th March, and now we are almost 30 days now. So in last 30 days, I don't think any of us would have witnessed this rapid speed of change around us. This is the pace of speed which probably we'll not even witness in our life next time. So the change at which things are happening around us is so fast, which every day scorecard, across India tickling up, the change are also happening fast. So we are fortunate to be in this kind of a scenario to have ever witnessed this absolutely rapid change and survive out of it. We would be so proud in times to come when we'll look back and say, okay, this was the kind of situation, this was the kind of and scenario we were in, and finally we were out and we survived and we are happy and we would be smiling ever after. So there are new ways, there are new perspective which will change, the new perspective of social distancing, new perspective of fear psychosis among people, new perspective of health related concerns. So everybody is going to get impacted, everybody, in terms of every venture, every startup, every enterprise. What would be the degree of impact? Yeah, I think it will depend upon many things, but two things which comes to my mind very clearly is the degree of social distancing that could be maintained and still you can perform your work, you can still deliver to your customer, and how much is your product or services is in the essential services or in the healthcare sector. So these are the two broad parameters which will decide which enterprise are at more risk, which kind of enterprises will have more impact, but the impact is for everyone. Just in a way in which the Zomatos of the world and Swiggies of the world have added so many things into their screen in terms of hygiene kitchens and social distancing deliveries and discrete stuff and all that. So I think everybody will have to start looking at those notions and start adding it to your standard operating procedures of your product development, your service delivery, your business development and everything. I think there are absolutely new ways now. Life will not be same after this corona times. Absolutely, there will be a new life. The new world is going to emerge after this, because it will have a long-term, deeper impact on our souls. It's not something which can be taken away just by one dose of medicine morning, evening, and after 1 week we'll be all fine. I don't think that kind of scenario, and we would have a much longer and a deeper impact of this. Innovation, yes, this is my favorite takeaway here. This is the time to innovate. No better time than this for us to actually look at this opportunity to innovate something new. New products, new processes, new ways of delivery, new ways of using technology. So there can be an innovation everywhere. For example, a very small example that we are trying to change our Gupshup edition to this kind of webinar edition. We have been doing Gupshup for last 6-7 years, but now, yes, because of the current situation, we realize that, okay, can we do a Gupshup over a webinar? It is an experiment. I'm not sure how far this kind of a Gupshups can really be done on a webinar, but yes, we have many such opportunities for all of us. Probably if I give our own example, next edition of Innopreneur might be completely changed. We may not have those physical rounds across cities, and we might have to do something drastically new to keep our activity moving forward. So these are the times to innovate, and I think we better use this opportunity to innovate, think of new ideas, think of the new scenario which will emerge because of this fear that people have gone into, this because of this epidemic, because of the situation that people are into. There are economic implications, there are social implications, there are psychological implications. So there are going to be implications of all this, but yes, it's time for us to innovate and keep the show go on. The show will have to go on. Whatever movie we all are writing, whatever story we all are writing, I think we have to keep writing our stories going forward. We cannot stop. There is absolutely no way that an entrepreneur can stop writing their own story. We have to keep writing our story. Few sentences will change, few paragraphs will change. Some things will emerge new, something will become absolutely few, but there are going to be new ways which will evolve. So you have to really look at the current situation and keep innovating. Yes, discovery. I think at least I am using this time very well, very well for my own discovery. So this is something which otherwise we would probably not do it at all. A lot of times we think this is more of spiritual, this is more of psychological, this is not for me. But I think discovering something about your own self, something about your own interest, your purpose will definitely will have an impact on your journey going forward. Maybe it's a startup journey, maybe it's an entrepreneur journey. I think the more you know about your own self, this is the time to introspect, do some bit of internal thought process, do spend some time out of your own, because we have time now. Otherwise, we were more in a mechanical schedule for the entire day. Morning used to come, sunrise, sunset, that's it. But now, since there is a small pause, maybe by not wanting, by not our choice, but yes, let's try to discover something about your own way. Let's try to see what path you want to follow forward. A lot of learnings have come out of this experience of last 30 days, and next 30 days are still going to give us much more experiences, much more lessons of life. So nobody is big small here. Everybody is impacted, right? From Donald Trump to a small person living next to our house in a slum. Everybody is shattered. Everybody is impacted in the same way out of this. This is a big lesson of humanity for all of us. So let's try to discover something in our own way. These are the best time to learn. If you thought you wanted more time to learn, this is the time to learn. I think we always used to complain we don't get time. This is a common statement that I have listened to numerous of people. Ki samay nahi hai, time nahi milta. Ab to time hai bhai, ab to karo. This is the time. This is the best time that you can use this pause. You can learn. If you did anything you wanted to learn in your life, for example, I started learning keyboard and guitar with my son. I always wanted to do this since my college days, but I realized why not now. So though I'm taking much more time, I'm not a very good student for my son, but yes, I'm making an attempt to learn something and use this time. You can learn a lot of your tech stuff, your professional skills. You can develop your knowledge. There's so much of stuff available out there. Like for example, you all are here in this webinar. It's what we are trying to use this time under this category of learning. So congrats to all of you and compliments to all of you. Keep this learning going, and I'm sure there are many more opportunities for us to learn different sort of things. You can learn from anyone. You can learn even if you do a chat with your father or with your mother or your brother or sister or some relative or some friend or some baju ki dukan wala or neighbor. Believe me, you learn something from them for sure, which otherwise may not happen in a daily routine life. Wish bucket, yes. We always used to create our huge list of wish buckets. So this time has come now. Whatever is possible, though we cannot move out. So if you had a wish bucket of traveling to many places, unfortunately, this is not the time. But if there are some kind of wishes you had always thought of, this is the time. Whatever you can do, sitting inside your house, sitting with your family, sitting with your friends, chatting with your friend, using internet, learning, knowledge, skill, hobbies. I think the time has come that you can finally start picking your items in your wish bucket. Extra mile. Yes, I think these are the times for extra mile, because whomsoever is able to do something wonderful in this time, they are the people who will go beyond the normal situation. So this is the time for extra mile. Whatever it could be a new innovation, you could contribute for people around you. You can simply do some volunteering if you are young, if you have time. This is the time to go out and start volunteering, because otherwise you would always felt main kabhi kar sakta tha but kabhi kiya nahi. So this is the time, start going, do volunteering. If you want to do some research, this is the time for you to do some new research on some new product, on some new innovation. If your revenues are down, if your business is halted, this is the time to go extra mile and start talking to your customer and understand their perspective more and more. Use this time. Everybody is available. Your customers are available. Your prospective employees are available. Your team members are available. There are people available around you. So use this time. Talk to them, understand them, develop your empathy, develop your understanding, and I'm sure when the times get back to normal, this experience is going to help you in a very big and a very, very significant way. So I think these were the few things which I wanted to start with in terms of my perspective of opportunity during this adverse time. So, I think a few very common questions that everybody would have in their mind. Probably I'll take one or two such questions based on my interaction that I've been doing with few people in my circle, my startups at Lemon, and my own team members. So it's very easy to say ki adversity hai, achha time hai, but what happens, I'm in a difficult situation with no money coming in, the work is halted, I have to pay so much of money to lending agencies, I have taken loans, I have done that, and I have to pay salaries and all that. But how do I manage my situation right now? I think yes, easy to say, but very difficult to experience and manage, and everybody is in the same kind of a boat. So my perspective is only that, yeah, it is difficult. Everyone knows about it. So it's absolutely fine. It's better we take it positively and see what best we can do about it. Because just for the sake of tripping over it, feeling bad about it, is not going to solve the problem. Problem is there. We all know it. Everybody knows, right from Narendra Modi to Donald Trump to everyone knows that there is a problem with every one of us is going to face today, and we all are facing today. Let's see what our small little micro level things that we could do. I think those are the things which would probably help us. So this is, I think, is something which I wanted to really share. Going forward now, so ये कुछ basic सवाल हैं कि business तो बंद हो गया है, काम तो हो नहीं रहा है, customer पैसा दे नहीं रहे हैं. A lot of people start using this as a reason for not paying you. Understand, a lot of people will use this as a reason for not paying you also. So ये भी होने वाला है. A lot of people will use this as a opportunity of not paying you. They will say कि अब तो ये time है. So I know all those things will keep on happening, and so apart from that, this is also times to ideate. I think from a self-discovery point of view, from an innovation point of view, this is the time to ideate something new. Think of new ways, think of new ideas, a lot of things around you. There are a lot of problems which are coming up for people now. Can you solve those problems? Can you take those problems as opportunity? Because as an entrepreneur, we will have to look at these problems more as a opportunity. So I think we need to look at this as an opportunity to see if we can ideate something new. If there is a problem that there are a lot of elderly people who are living alone, they don't have their children, unke paas koi hai nahi unka dhyan rakhne wala, and they are in lockdown. Opportunity for someone to start seeing if you can address this kind of a problem in some way in which you can address it and solve it. So I think there can be many new ideas. This unprecedented situation and time will lead to more ideas and innovations to come for sure. I think one thing that I can definitely imagine in the next 2 years, there are going to be few so powerful ideas that we could not have even imagined. They will impact our life, and our life will get changed in a way. When the social media came, our life were changed. I can anticipate a similar scenario in next 1 to 2 years. Something new will come, which we don't know, which we cannot visualize because it is new. We can't visualize. But after this pandemic time is over, after this corona is over, I'm sure there are going to be few major things in our life that will change. Some new concepts will come. Some new startups are going to absolutely take it over from there now. So can you be part of that story? Can you be those kind of stories? Can you be that entrepreneur to think of and bring a solution to the new emerging problem? So the problems are new. Nobody had anticipated. No, nobody was prepared for the problem. Understand, the best of the scientific team, research team, nobody was prepared for this problem. So it's new for everyone. Everyone is 60 days or 90 days old for this problem. So there's absolutely that somebody had more of an advantage. Ki usko to IIT mein padhaya gaya tha. He got to learn this in IIM, so he can solve this problem more. Fortunately, there is nothing of that favor can come in real life scenario. The uncertainty, the problem, the degree is absolutely new for everyone. So the opportunity is also same for everyone. If you can solve it, why not move forward and solve it? Apart from that, I think there's also one more point that I wanted to touch upon here, is because a lot of people would be concerned about funding kaisa hoga abhi aise time pe, to funding to kaise hoga bhai, Sensex dook chuka hai, gold prices are going down, ab real estate ka to pata nahi kya hone wala hai. So there are absolutely the difficult times, and investors are also going to get conservative. Yes, if I have to look from my own personal perspective, yes, I would want to get conservative. Ki par jo hai pehle usko rakho, dekho abhi kya hota hai, and then see what is the best call that you can take. So if in case your startup is can bring a story connecting or intersecting with corona times, you have a definite advantage. If you can mention this to people that, okay, because of my startup, because of my idea, or I'm bringing a pivot, or I'm changing, or I'm bringing a small twist in my startup or a product or service, that it can become complementary to the fight against corona. So if you have a concept which is somewhere, or which can get connected to health of people, which can get connected to the impact arising out of this scenario, then definitely you have an edge that you can at least start approaching, and you can claim that you have this fantastic opportunity. Otherwise also, yes, you'll have to start thinking ways in which you can keep your startup or insulated your startup from the current impact. So if you can insulate it, if you can have a nice insulating layer around it, why not? You are still there in the game. We all are still there in the race. So you don't have to worry about it. The startup funding sentiments are going to be low. But again, at the same time, my perspective has always been that because of this, it will be an advantageous for us not to purely depend upon funding or external investment sources. We would be compelled, whether we like it or we not like it, but it is for our betterment that we start looking at some kind of an value which we can give to customer, and we can make it revenue generating. So I think these are the times for us to make it revenue and not just to depend upon external funding. In case your startup needs a significant funding for commercialization or for productization, maybe it's time to put it on a hold or put it on a back burner for a few months here and there. start looking at some other ways in which you can carry on your learning journey forward. Join some other organization who is somewhere near to your concept. Be a part of some startup. For example, we have a scheme called Entrepreneur in Residence where we invite entrepreneurs to join us on some vertical, join us on some project, lead them, drive them, generate revenue and earn their livelihood also. So I'm sure there are going to be many such opportunities in case you have to put your startup on a hold for some time. But take a conscious call very quickly. It's not time to procrastinate right now. Let's not procrastinate. Whatever is best possible opportunity, we can take it now. So adversities are the best seeding grounds for new pathways. Yes, this is what we have been discussing. This is what I have been trying to reemphasize with you all. So let's try to use this. For people who don't know this, we are running What an Idea campaign on our Innopreneurs platform. So if you have any ideas that you can submit regarding Corona or COVID-19, definitely log on to innopreneurs.in and submit your ideas. We are collecting a lot of ideas which people are suggesting on isolation, social distancing, cure, prevention, impact of this pandemic and all that. So please do check in, do log in, and Innopreneur is the place for you to submit your ideas if you have anything that you want to suggest and around Corona. Let's celebrate life. There are difficulties. I know we at the back of the mind, everybody is going through that uncertainty. We all are in the same uncertainty, but at least as a country, India is more better position to handle this kind of crisis because this conservative thinking of saving that our elders, that our parents have been carrying on for last many, many years. This so-called conservative thinking of saving is going to be most useful for all of us in this most turbulent time. So these are times also for us to accept, acknowledge, and recognize what elders have been saying around for us. This Indian culture and Indian society is very, very strongly rooted society. Our civilization is very, very deeply rooted, and the wisdom is much beyond that we can even imagine. So let's use this wisdom. We are absolutely in a better situation as a country, as a society, to handle this kind of situation, because most of us, many of us, will not have a livelihood challenge right now. We have a lot of support systems with us. We have families. We have so many people to really support us. So let's celebrate life. You can read this small article that I have penned down, which is posted on Medium. Let's celebrate life, where I mentioned about 19 recipes in which you can still celebrate your life today. There are 19 ways that you can celebrate your life in COVID-19 days. So if you are interested, please do check in and please do check this out on Medium. If any one of you is interested for one-on-one meeting with us at Lemon, you can definitely check it out. You can call this number. You can call this number, or you can also write a mail to outreach. So do write to us, do call us. We will definitely be there to help you out. Last few slides on what we are, what we do. I'll not spend much time on this. Most of you are familiar with Lemon. Most of you know we have been into this entrepreneurship space, startup space for last 7 years. Probably one of the only private self-sustaining ecosystems in the country. So now I can see some questions coming up in the chat box. So I would try to take this question from one by one and see how can I best respond to this question. So Krishnakant, what do you suggest for me to handle the Q&A?
I think, sir, we shall take the questions in the chat box only, because if we open it to open the mic, it would take time and it would create unnecessary disturbance also. So I think we should proceed ahead for taking questions in the chat box only.
Okay, sure. Thank you, Krish. So I would have loved to take questions in a real time manner, but I think because of the constraints that we have in front of us right now, let us appreciate the constraint and see what best we can do. So let me browse through my chat box. I can see so many familiar people. Hi and hello to everyone. I'm sorry I'll not be able to mention your name right now, because there are so many of you. My God, I'm so happy to see so many familiar names, right? Not just from India, but from outside India also. Wow. So good to see your names here again in front of me after so many months and years. So wonderful to see. So I'll start taking questions now. So there is this question which is coming from you can keep posting your questions in the chat box. In the meanwhile, I am browsing through. So how can we get an investment at an ideation stage, steps involved? So this Hoshang has a question. I think this question is not linked to this theme of the webinar, because this is a very generic question that normally, how do we approach investors at an ideation stage? So it's very tough to approach an investor at an ideation stage, because what you're carrying is just a piece of imagination. And with a piece of imagination, if you want somebody to give you money, I think it's going to be tough. But in case you have some IP, if you have some kind of a patent or some kind of an intellectual property that you're trying to build out of your idea, the chances are better for you to approach investors. But I don't think, unless you have that, these are not a very favorable times to look for funding at an ideation stage. Better implement, execute few steps, and then maybe we'll be able to raise confidence of investors. There is one more question. How much time will it take to normalize? Oh my God, I don't think I can be an astrologer at this point of time. I cannot predict, but definitely I can see, if you have to imagine the situation which we had on maybe 20th of February, 20 February 2020. It's a good date, so I'm just taking it as an example. So 2020 to 2020. So if somebody